Today we will discuss concept of selection, that is the capabilities of select statement in SQL. What is a selection? Whenever we are having the data is available, from that one data we have to select specific row or set of rows. That concept is called selection. Let here currently we are having the schema is available. In this one schema we are having a table is available. In this one table we are having implies. In imply we are having the different records are there. If we want to retrieve all of those implies in department 90, to retrieving the row or set of rows, set of records from the table, that concept is called selection. So when we have this one table implies from this one, we are retrieving the specific set of rows. That concept is called selections. So selection is related to retrieve the row or set of row from the table. How we can do it? Let's take the example over here. Let we are having in SQL statement, we are having the different tables or columns are here. We say that employee ID. Next one, we are having the employee name. Name. Third one, we are having another, let me say, salary. Next one, we say we are having the column hire date. And last one, we say that department ID. When we want to retrieve the data, we say that here we are having employee ID 1. Then next one, we are having the name. Name is here Ali. Then next one, we say salary. We are having the 16,000. Hire date 12/5/03. Then we are having the department ID. We have department IDs here 10. Next one, we see that employee ID is 2. Name is Rafi. Salary is this one. Hire date is 2/7/14. And we are having next one, the department ID is, we say again 10. Next one, employee ID 3. Name is here Asad. Salary is here 8,000. Hire date is 1/5/19, and department is here 20. Okay, now if we are having the data is available, from this one data we want to retrieve the record of all of those employees, as employee who ID is 2, whose name is Rafi, or all of those employees whose salary is 40,000, all of those employees whose department ID is 10. So whenever we have a data from all of those, we are limiting the record from the table. That concept is called selection. How we let we have it from this one table, if we want to retrieve the data of the specific employee, like we say that we want to display the data of only one employee, and that is we are having the Rafi. So how we say employee ID, we are having the two name is here Rafi, and salary is here 40,000. Height is here 2nd sept 14, and department is here. So we limit this one record, and here we are having only one record is here. If we see that we are having the department ID 10, so it will display two different records over here. This one first one record as well as second one record. Ali and Rafi record will be displayed. Why? Because its department ID is 10. Where condition is true, then it will display the record. How we can use it for this one? Using the concept of where clause, we may be able to restrict the row, or we may be able to limit the row. In where clause, we have to use the where clause. In select statement, when we use where clause, it limits the number of records. How we can do it? Let's see. That here we are having employee table. Check the description of employees. So here we are having different columns are there. If we want to display the data of the employee ID, first names, last name, we are having email, and we are having the salary. And next one we have in the department ID. That is not a case sensitive from employees. It display all the record 107 records. But if we want to limit, let if we want to display the record of employee ID 177, how we can display it? For that one, select employee ID, first name, last name, email, salary, and department ID. From employees, we have to use the where clause, where employee ID is equal to 177. So it will limit the records and display all of those employees whose employee ID is 177. So we are having only one person whose employee ID is 177. Let we want to display another record. We say all of those employees whose employee ID, first name, last name, email, hire date, salary, department ID, from employees, where department ID is equal to, let me say department ID is equal to 90. Display all of those employees whose department ID is 90. Condition will be checked in department ID column. Then where it find that department ID value is 90, then it will display the record. So department ID 90 record will be displayed. The different column values, employee ID, first name, last name, email, hire date, salaries, and department ID will be displayed for all of those employees whose department ID is 90. Let's see. So here we are having the three different employees are there. Whose department ID is 90, it will display the record. Now, here in where clause, we are using the numeric value. If we are having the character value, string value, then it become the case sensitive. SQL is not a case sensitive, but when we are having the character value, that is the case sensitive. Character value must be enclosed in a string, in a single quotation marks. So whenever we are having the character string or that value, that must be enclosed in a single quotation marks. SQL is a case sensitive for the character value, and that is format sensitive for the date value. For the date, we are having the default format is day dash 3-digit month and 2-digit year. That is the default format. That if you want to retrieve the data of Steven employee whose first name is Steven, how? Select employee ID, first name and last name. Table is here from employees, where we see that first name is equal to, whenever we are having the character string, that must be enclosed in a single quotation marks. So that is a Steven. In database, we are having initial character is uppercase letter. If we use it over here in lowercase letter, then it will not display any record over here. So let's see first. So we are having the two different employees whose employee ID is either 100 or 128, whose their first name is Steven. If we use same query, but we are using Everest for the Steven, initial S is lowercase letter. Let's see, it will display any record or not. It doesn't display any record, although we are having the name Steven is there, but SQL is a case sensitive. For the characters, SQL is a case sensitive, and for the date format, SQL is a format sensitive. Let display the records. Select employee ID. We are having the last name, then salary and hire date. From employees, where hire date is equal to, we set at 17 June 2013. We see that SQL is a dead format sensitive, and for the character it is a case sensitive for the values. So 17 June, we use it over here 13. That is no record selected. Here we are having the 17 June 03. Let's see if you want to use it over here 03. So it display one record, the employee whose hire date is 17 June 03. So in this way, we may be able to retrieve the record from the database, and we can limit the record. Now whenever we want to limit the record in the database, we can use a different comparison operator. We are having the different comparison operator. First one, we are having equal comparison operator that we already discussed. Greater than, let me say salary value is greater than, salary value is less than. For all the numeric value, we can use greater than symbols. Greater than or equal. Salary value is greater than 10,000. Salary is less than 10,000. Less than or equal, not equal. Then we will discuss between and like is null. All of these are the comparison operator. So first we are having equal. We already discussed that when where salary is equal to 10,000. All of those implies whose salary is 10,000. Select employee ID. First name. Last name. Salary. And department ID. Table is here. Implies where salary equal to 10,000. So it displays all of those employees whose salary is 10,000. If we want to use it over here, another comparison operator, we see that salary value is greater than or equal to. Greater than equal can be used for any type of comparison, any type of the values. That can be the character value, string value, del format value, or numeric value. Greater than or equal, less than or equal, greater than and less than. These comparison operator can be used either for the date format or that can be used for the numeric values. Now we want to display all of those employees whose salary is greater than 10,000. So for that one, we have to use select employee ID, first name, last name, salary, department ID from employees where we set it salary greater than 10,000. It's been 10,000 is not included. It's mean all of these employees record will not be displayed. Other than all of those employees whose salary value is greater than 10,000, it will display the record. So here we are having 15 different employees whose salary is greater than 10,000. 24,000, 17,000, 12,000, 11,000, 14,000, 30,500. But if we use it over here, greater than or equal to 10,000, it's mean 10,000 is also included. So here these four are also included. It's 15 plus 4, that will display the 19. Where greater than or equal. So for that one, to use it over here, greater than or equal, we have to use greater than equal symbol over here. So it display it over here 19 different records. It display, you can see here we are having an employee whose salary is equal to also 10,000. Right? Here we are having all the other employees whose salary is greater than 10,000, whose salary is 10,000 or greater than 10,000. Same. If you want to display all of those employees whose salary is less than 3,000, first name, last name, salary, table is there from employees where salary less than 3,000. So here we are having 24 different employees whose salary is less than 3,000. We can use it over here, less than or equal. So for that one, less than or equal to 3,000. Same we can use it over here. Let me say that we can use same concept for the date format. Select employee ID, first name, hire date, and then we see data, salary from implies where her date greater than or greater than and equal to. We say that is the date format sensitive. Date is the format sensitive. We say that first February 07. Are those implies who were hired after the 1st February 2007? It will display the records of all of those employees. So if we want to display all of those employees who were hired before 1st January 2002, from employees where hire date less than or equal to 1st January 02. Okay, now here we have spelling mistakes are there. Month names are not JB, so that's why error message January. It display only one person whose hire date is in the year of 2001. All of other employees were hired after the 1st January 2002. Now here we see that less than, greater than, less than or equal, greater than or equal. Similarly, I am using another select employee ID, first name, last name, salary and department ID. Tabulate there from employees where department ID is equal to 50. Spelling of employee ID is incorrect. M is missing. Where department ID is equal to 50. So it displays 45 different records. All of those employees whose department ID is 50. But if you want to display all of those employees whose department is other than 50, right? We don't need the employees belong to the department ID 50. That we need all of those employees whose department ID can be 10, 20, 30, 40, but not 50, 60, 70, 80, any other, but not 50. So for that one, we are having the concept of NOT, comparison operator. How we can use? Select first name, last name, employee ID, first name, last name, salary, department ID, from employee, where department ID. We can use it over here, less than or equal. That is also used for the NOT operator. It means department ID NOT equal. Or we can use for this one, then exclamation marks and equal. This one is also used for the NOT equal. Right? So anyone we can use it over here. Where department ID NOT equal to? We see that 50. Now it will display all of those employees whose department ID is other than 50. It will display employee ID, first name, last name, salary and department ID. So here 61 different records are there, but we couldn't find the employees belong to the department ID 50. Now we discuss the different comparison operator. Equal, greater than, less than, less than or equal, greater than or equal and not equal. Now we are having other comparison operator like between and end. Between and end operator are used for to provide the range for the values. We see that all of those employees whose salary ranges from 10,000 to 12,000. 10,000 is also included and 12,000 is included. How we can use between and end comparison operator? So for that one, select first name, last name, and salary. Have their firm employees where salary, we have to use a display the range of the salary from the 10,000 and 12,000, where salary between 10,000, it's mean 10,000 is included, and 12,000, this one 12,000 is included, both of these are inclusive, right? And the range, we want to include this one. If we don't want to include and we want to use the between and end comparison operator, for that one we have to use it over here, like 11,099 and 10,001. But if we want to include it, fine. All of those implies whose salary value is in the range of 10,000 and 12,000. And 10,000 and 12,000 are inclusive. 12,000, 10,000. It displayed over here 11 different records. If you want to display all of those implies whose employee ID range is from 120 to 125. So how we can display? Select first name, employee ID, first name, last name, salary from implies where employee ID between we say 120 and 135. So here 120 is included as well as 135 is included. 120 and here 135. All employees whose employee ID range is from 120 and 135. It display all of those employees. Now, same we can use between and comparison operator for date format. How? We see that select employee ID, first name, hire date from table name is here employees, where hire date between, now that must be enclosed in a single quotation marks and that is a format sensitive. We said first January 04 and we say the range is here first January, or we say it 31st December 04. All of those employees who were hired at the year 2004. So first January 2004 and 31st January 04. So hired that is, it means all of it display all of those employees who were hired in the year 2004. So we are having 10 different employees whose hire date is in the year of 2004. 18 July, 14 July, June, 1st October, 17 Feb, 4 Feb, 27 Jan, and others. This one is related to the between and comparison operator. Now, another comparison operator, that is, we have in comparison operator. And in comparison operator, whenever we are having list of the values, it match with the list of the values and display the record. How? Select, we see that employee ID, first name, last name, hire date, and department ID from employees, where employee ID n, we want to use the n comparison operators. In n comparison operator, we have to provide the list. We say that n list employee id varies, we say that 120 or 135 or 148 or 178 or 202. We want to provide the list over here. So employee id is 120, 135, 140, 178 and 202. It will display the record of the employee id, first name, last name, hire date and department id. So here it displays records 120, 135, 148, 178 and 202. That if we want to display, if we want to provide the detail over here, the list over here related to the first name or last name, let me say we want to provide the list for the first name. So how? Select employee id, first name, last name, hire date, department id from employee where first name in. So first name, that is a character format. Character string, that must be enclosed in a single quotation marks. We said as Smith, Nana, and that must be enclosed in a single quotation marks. We are having the pet, single quotation marks, and we want the value over here, the Matthew. So we want to provide the list over here in the in comparison operator. So in comparison operator displays the records. We use it over as Smith, Nana, Pat, and Matthew in the first names. But it doesn't display all the other values. It displays just Pat. Pat record is here, right? Let me use it over here, Nana. Maybe spelling mistakes are there. Smith, spelling mistakes are it dead, doesn't it? Okay, here we use it over here. Matthew. So spelling of this one is here M-A-T-T-H-E-W and I use M-A-T-H-E-W. So whenever value is not available in the list, so it will not display any record. If we use it over here, where first name is equal to Matthew and spelling is this one M-A-T-T-E-W, it will not display. It says that no record is selected. So in the list, what are the value available in the database? It will display all of those records from the database. Same we can apply for the hire date or any other column. This one is the n comparison operators. Now another comparison operators, that is the like comparison operators. Like comparison operator match a character pattern. That is used for the pattern matching. Let we see that in employee table, all of those employee whose first name started with A, from employee where first name. So we have to use which one comparison operator? Like we see that first name started with A, so use it over here, like comparison operator, use single quotation marks and then A, start with A. Now n number of character can be there after this one, zero character, one or many. So for that one, other character can be any. So for that one, we have to use the person symbols. So it's mean initial character, starting character will be the uppercase A, not lowercase A. After that one, we may have n number of character. So here, all of those employees whose first name is A display all of the employee record. If we want to display all of those employees whose last name is A, So for that one, we have to use the A at the end, and before that one, we have to use the last name ended at A. So we have to use the A at the end, and before A, we have to use the person symbols. How? Where last name, and we see that like last name ended at A, so A is here, that must be end. Before that one, n number of characters can be here, so we have to use the person symbol. So here last name ended with A, this one, so this one is used for the pattern match. Person is used for the n number of characters. We see that all of those implies whose first name is A, that is an uppercase letter like this one, Elena, and last name is A, and that is a lowercase letter. How we can use it for that one? Select first name, last name, and salary table is here. From implies where first name like, we say initial character is A, that is an uppercase letter. After that one, n number of characters can be there, then we have to use the person symbol, that can be 0, 1 or many, and last character must be A. So for this one pattern matching, it will display only two records whose first name is here A, uppercase letter, and last name here in the A in the lowercase letter. Now, if we see that all of display all of those implies whose second character is A, not initial, whose last name second character is A. First character can be anyone, that can be A, B, C, up to Z. Third, fourth, and all the other character can be anyone. So for that one, for one character, we have to use the underscore symbol. How? Select first name, last name, salary. Where last name like first character can be anyone. So we are not using it every person symbol. Person symbol is used for any number of the characters. We have to use the underscore. This one underscore is used for a single character. First character can be anyone, A to Z. Next character must be A. And after this one, n number of character can be there. So here, in the last names, second character is A. Everywhere we will find second character is A. If we want to display that all of those implies whose second last character is E or O, whose second last character is O, how we can use it over here? So for that one, same query, I'm not writing it again, where last name like second last character. So we see that A is here, that must be a second last. So A, after that one, we are using underscore, and before that one A, we may have n number of characters can be there, and then use the single. So it's mean second character, second last character may be any, second last character must be A, before that one n number of characters 0, 1 or any, and last character can be anyone. So here in last name, second last character is A. If we want to display all of those implies whose first name contained 2E at any position, but that must have the 2E. So how we can use it over here? That contains the 2E. Select first name, last name, salary from implies where first name like, we see that that must contain E, person symbol E, that can be at the start. After that one, in number of characters 1, 2, 10, 100, and if you, and then we have the another E, and after that one we may have any other n number of the character executed. So here we are having the all of those names whose name containing the two E. Here double E is here. Here we are having E and E. Here we are having the E at the middle at the end. So all of those names whose first name containing the two E. Yes. If you want to display all of those names whose first name contain second character is E and fourth character is A, how we can use? Where first name like second character is E, third character can be anyone, fourth character is A, and after that one n number of character can be there. So we are having only this one name, second character is E, fourth character is A, and after that one we may have n number of character. Same like operator can be used for the date format. That all of those employees display all of those employees who were hired and 2008. How we can display? So that is 08 ended with the 2008. How we can use it over here? Select first name, last name, hired it from employees where hire date like ended with, we are having the 08. Before 08 we may have n number of characters, so we have person symbol. It will display all of those employees who were hired whose hired date is ended with 08. It means 2008 is the year. Previously we discussed between and end comparison operator for to solve this one. All of those employees whose hire date is between 1st January 08 and 31st December 08. Now hire date like ended with the 08. Use the semicolon, press enter. All of those employees who were hired at the year 2008, it displays the record over here. It's all about like comparison operator. Now another comparison operator, that is the is null. Let we set it, select first name, last name, manager ID, and commission PCB. From employees where display all of those employees whose manager ID who don't have a manager. So it's mean manager ID value is null. So for that one we will not write it over here manager ID equal to null. So we have to write it over here manager ID is null. It will display all of those employees whose manager ID value is null. So only one person is here, King Steven. Steven is here whose manager ID value is absence of the value. If we set it display all of those employees whose commission PCT value is null, or the people who are not getting any commission, so what we will do? Where commission PCT is null. So it say that here we are having the different employees, 72 different employees who are not getting any commission. Commission PCT value is not available over here for all of these. But if we say that display all of those employees who are receiving commission, so for that one we have to use is not null. select first name, last name, manager ID, commission PCT, from employee, where commission PCT is not null. So it will display all of those employees who are not receiving the commission, who are receiving the commission. So we are adding the value for all the commission PCT for all of these employees. It's all about selection and limiting the records in a database. So here we discuss the different comparison operator like equal, greater than, less than, less than or equal, greater than or equal, not equal. Then we discuss between and comparison operator, like comparison operator, is null and is not null. Thanks for watching the video.